Welcome to the One Minute Apologist. We interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions. What is the millennium?
The millennium is a thousand-year period of time. At the end of time, it's really the last chapter of human history. It's not the beginning of eternity, it's the last chapter of human history. When it's described in the Bible, in the fullness of times, and God brings all things together. It's a period of peace and prosperity, a period when Jesus reigns on a throne from Jerusalem. He's king over all the earth, where evil will be done away with as fast as it occurs. In this life, and he will rule with a rod of iron, so he'll have to put down whatever evil does come in rebellion, where the earth will be restored to its primitive state again. We have animals that are normally vicious animals lying down together, the ox and the lamb, and with the lion, and so forth. But primarily, it's when God brings everything together in the last great chapter of human history to prove one point he's been trying to make throughout all of the ages. That man is a sinner in every condition, even when the devil is tied up, which he'll be tied up for the 1,000 years. Even when there's no devil, so we can't say the devil made me do it, we're still rebels against God, because at the end of the millennium, the devil will be released from his prison, fire will come down, and he'll gather together numberless peoples to sand the seashore to rebel against Christ. Fire will come down from heaven and destroy him, and it will all be over. So God will have proven that in every age, whether we have conscience or whether we don't have conscience or human government or law or promise or grace, when we don't have any devil here at all to tempt us, we are still rebels and we're still sinners. And apart from God, we'll destroy ourselves.